Nick here from Technuevo, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're looking at the Miele CM6360 coffee machine. Last time I reviewed a Miele product, I called it Miele, but a lot of people said it sounds like Sheila, so Miele. Hopefully I'm saying it right now and you all approve and don't take it out of me in the comments. So the CM6360 is one of Miele's mid to high-end coffee machines, and it's an all-singing, all-dancing bean-to-cup machine with convenience in mind. There is a lot to get through, and I'll try to cover everything. For an automatic coffee machine, it's medium size in footprint and shouldn't look too out of place on your kitchen worktop. The front of the machine at the top is the touch control buttons and display. There are several buttons. The first few are preset coffee types like espresso, cappuccino, standard coffee, etc. And then the other buttons are used to control the machine and change various settings. There are quick buttons for selecting two portions, double shot of espresso, and menu button, and then associated arrows and OK and back buttons to use that menu. There is also a Wi-Fi or mobile start button, they call it, but more on that later. Below the controls, two outlets, the main dual dispenser for the coffee and milk, which you can slide up and down to suit the size of your cup. Then to the left, a fixed outlet for hot water only. There is then a separate milk container made from glass with a metal tube inside, which connects to the side of the main dispenser via a detachable plastic tube. Below the dispensers is the drip tray where your coffee sits and any excess liquid is also stored. The drip tray pulls out from the front, allowing you to discharge the liquid down the sink and throw away your used coffee grounds or compost them if you want to. Moving around to the right hand side of the machine, there is a removable panel on hinges which gives you access to the brewing unit, which you can remove for cleaning. On the left hand side, the removable water tank that you can fill up from the tap. The water tank has a volume of 1.8 litres, the milk container 0.5 litres and the drip tray 0.75 litres. Lastly, to the top of the machine is a nifty little rubber warming plate which heats up when the machine is turned on, and the idea is to heat your coffee cups that are stored on the mat before using them. The mat gets warm, you can feel it from touch, but it's mild and no way will it hurt you at all. Behind that warming mat, a chute allowing you to insert ground coffee if you wanted, although that's limited to one portion of coffee at a time. And then behind that, a much larger hopper for your coffee beans, which will approximately hold 300 grams. Straight out of the box, it will make you a number of tasty beverages, standard size espressos, cappuccinos, and so on. I would say they're more a cup size, which is 250 ml, I think. Not a mug size that some of us Brits like to have our brews in. Using the machine is very straightforward. Plug it in, put your beans in the hopper, fill the water tank, add some milk if you want, a milky coffee, and turn the machine on. Put your cup under the outlet, select your drink, and it will be made. The screen shows you the process with a progress bar, so you'll know when your coffee is done. If the array of default coffees are not enough for you, or you prefer your drink made a specific way, then you can enter expert mode and edit your drink. You can change the portion size to perfectly fill your favorite mug. You can adjust the grind setting of the beans. You can change the quantity of the bean ground, and you can change the brewing temperature, and you can save all of those changes under your own profile. I tried a few out. I actually wanted more hot water in my cappuccino, and it worked a treat. Alternatively, you can scroll through the menus and dispense hot water, hot milk, or frothy milk manually, and when you've added enough to your drink, press the button illuminated and it will stop dispensing. A note on the grind setting, it's actually set manually, and there is a 5-point slider inside the machine where the brewing unit is. Don't forget the double shot and two portion buttons too, for an extra shot or to make two drinks in one go. There is no milk wand with this, and I did try dispensing some hot milk and frothy milk, mix them together and make some latte art with a single shot, but the milk didn't texture right, so don't even bother. You can also use the machine to make a cup of tea, and it gets quite specific. You can select which type of tea you're going to make: white, black, green, herbal, fruit, or Japanese. And depending on which one you select, depends on the water temperature and brewing time. If you went for a black tea, the water will dispense at about 78 degrees with a brewing time of 3 minutes, while a Japanese tea has a lower water temperature of 65 degrees and will only brew for 1.5 minutes. Again, if those temperatures and timings don't quite work for you, you can adjust them in the expert mode. As I've mentioned some temperatures there, I also took some manual readings with my thermometer, and I got approximately 60 degrees with an espresso. Cafe au lait was 58 degrees, hot milk was 50 degrees, and the hot water came out at about 75 degrees as well. I almost forgot, the machine can be connected to your home network via Wi-Fi, and you can use the Miele app to dispense drinks. You connect to the machine to your network via the app. It's pretty straightforward, and then it allows you to make drinks. There is a button machine that turns the wireless option on, and it can only be used once. So when you press the button on the machine, the drinks options within the apps become ungrayed, and you can select a drink. The machine then starts to dispense like normal, but does make various sounds, and the lights flash as well as a warning to those around you that a drink is being made. It's pretty obvious, but you can only make one drink at a time, then you have to press the button again, which is fine because you need to actually go and move the first drink out of the way and put an empty cup under the dispenser. Now you're probably thinking, great, I can make a coffee from bed first thing in the morning, get dressed, and then go down to the kitchen and it will be there waiting for you. Well, yes, you can. The machine does have an automatic switch off option though, which is set to 20 minutes as default, but you can increase this to 9 hours if you wanted to. So you need to do that first. You also have to remember to leave the machine on, and you have to press the mobile start button as well. One thing to consider, if you want a milky coffee, you've got to leave the milk out all night in the glass container, which isn't ideal. There are various other settings as well, including an eco mode, barista mode, latte mode, and a party mode, which turns the machine into hardcore mode when you need to make lots of coffees in a short amount of time for all your friends and family. You can also do your own water test or ask your water supplier and find out how hard your water is, input that into the machine, and then the cleaning notifications will change to suit, i.e. the harder the water, the more often it will ask you to be cleaned. Now, the machine will tell you when it's out of water or if it needs cleaning or emptying, but it will not tell you when you're out of beans or milk, so you need to check them manually. A few times I got caught short on the milk, thinking that there was enough in the container for my drink, but it wasn't. And then instead of milk, I just got steam. Also, the drip tray is completely filled to the top when it tells you to empty it. Every time I took the tray out of the machine and carried it to the sink, I spilt dirty water somewhere along the journey. Every time you turn the machine on and off, it will rinse through the internal pipework and the milk pipework, which is great, but it does mean the drip tray fills up even quicker. When it cleans itself, it does make quite a mess and will leave the metal drip tray and back panel with steamy residue. And when it dries, it doesn't look that good. Now that's quite a lot to get through, but I think I've covered most of the important points. I use the machine every day for 2 weeks, making various types of coffees, the odd tea, and hot milk with cocoa for my children as well. Although it took a while to get used to the sizes of the coffees, they came out hot enough for me, the proportions were good, not too milky, a strong coffee taste, and they were impressive to look at, especially the latte macchiatos. Taste-wise, they of course tasted good because I used my favorite Lavazza bean. I like that it cleans itself often, especially flushing through the milk pipes, which is great. It's very user-friendly and the app is an added bonus. I would have liked there to be a bit more hype from the main dispenser to the drip tray. I have a few of those nice glass cups for lattes, but they wouldn't fit. It looks good, it's well built, and if well maintained, should last you a very long time. It's not cheap at £1,400 here in the UK, and I'm going to say part of that is the branding, but if you like Miele and you like the convenience, this is a great machine. That is a wrap on this video. If you have stuck around to the end, then thank you very much. If you want to see more videos in the future, make sure to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up.